prison.
He's dead.
What's the matter?
Dead.
Miss Sullivan, ho!
You've got to come.
Makes you think he was dead.
He's dead. I saw him.
Like the man in the woods?
No. I haven't seen him, but I knew he was there. And there was someone in the house.
Who?
Oh, I've never seen him. I've just heard him breathing.
Breathing?
It was the same as...
Same as what?
When I was a little girl.
The day you were attacked?
Uh-huh.
Well, what does that tell you?
What?
Well, you are back where it all happened. I mean, everything around you, everything must, stimulate your memories. Must make your subconscious relive the moment.
Are you saying that I'm imagining all these things?
Look, I'm not a psychiatrist. I'm just asking you to be logical. Look, you saw Harold dead in the bathtub, then he disappeared. Then you saw him dead again in the car, he disappeared again. Now, is that logical? I am suggesting that perhaps Harold has taken your father's place by marrying Miriam. Perhaps your subconscious rejects the idea. Perhaps so much so that it wants Harold to be the one who raped you. It wants Harold to be dead. Well, would you at least consider the possibility?
Thank you, Doctor.
Susan. It will take time. Come and see me whenever you want. Even if it is my day off.
Susan, where have you been? I've been looking all over for you.
Just went for a drive.
Well, you should have left me a note or something. I've been frantic.
I'm sorry, Mother.
You sure you're all right?
I'm sure.
Back to the kitchen for me. I'm barbecuing hamburgers and baking beans.
Can I help?
Don't you dare. That kitchen looks like World War III hit it.
Excuse me, ma'am. I thought I'd go down to the woods. That fox is still about.
I'll come with you.
Well, I won't get very much shooting done with you around.
I know. That's why I'm coming with you.
Work up a good appetite. I've got hamburgers stacked to the ceiling.
Your mother worries about you. She's a lovely lady, and she loves you very much.
I know, but sometimes she treats me as though I was still only 12 years old.
But you were sick, and she doesn't want you to take any chances.
John, let's go this way.
No, miss. Your mother.
Please, come on. You were here that day, weren't you?
What day?
The day I was attacked.
Please, miss. Yes.
Tell me about it.
I'd rather not. Your mother.
My mother said that whatever happens, don't remind Susan of the day that she was raped.
Please, miss.
But don't you understand? I want to be reminded of it. That's the reason I came home. You were the one who found me, weren't you?
Yes. Your father called me. You disappeared from the party, and he was worried. He asked me to look for you. I found you here.
That's all?
That's all. I carried you back to the house. I didn't even know if you were still breathing.
You left the house that same night.
I never saw you again. Until the other day.
Did you see Harold that day?
He was at the party.
I know that, but did you see him there?
He was there.
Miss Susan.
Playhouse today.
You did what?
My dolls are still there.
You went inside?
Mm-hmm.
Darling, why torment yourself?
No, I'm glad I went. I was in the playhouse and I felt nothing other than a sort of detached interest. Now that's good. That's very good. It means that Dr. Schweitzman was right.
Well, darling, Dr. Schweitzman may be right in making you revisit this place with all its memories, but I'm not so sure.
But Mother, I told you how I felt in the playhouse. I know I'm getting better.
All right, all right. But if you were really getting better, how do you explain these hallucinations you've been having? Oh, I grant you. You may have seen somebody in the woods or the garden. It's not likely, but it's possible. But how do you explain the other things? Seeing Harold dead in the bathtub, dead in the car outside, and this fixation that someone is following you around the house at night.
Dr. Lomas has been talking to you.
Well, of course he has.
He shouldn't have.
After all, I am your mother.
He still shouldn't have told you.
Well, he did, and the only reason I'm bringing it up is because I'm still very worried about you.
Mother, hasn't it ever occurred to you that perhaps I am not imagining these things?
Of course it hasn't. Hello. Oh, yes, Harold. Oh, well, let's just forget the whole thing. Harold, Susan is here. Would you speak to her, please? Speak to Harold.
Hello?
I'm
fine, thank you.
I'll be home tomorrow. We'll put your mother back home.
Yes, all right.
Yes. Mm-hmm. No, I will pick you up myself. All right, goodbye. We're picking him up at the airfield tomorrow. Harold is coming home tomorrow.
Yes, I know. He told me.
You're not dressed. Harold's plane gets in less than an hour.
I'm not going, Mother.
All right, then I won't go either. I'll send John.
No, I've caused you enough trouble already.
Oh, Susan.
Come on now, or you'll be late.
All right. We'll come straight home.
Okay, goodbye. Hello? Oh, hello. Hello, Dr. Loomis. No, she's just left for the airport. What? Yes? All right.
I've seen him twice, and both times he was dead.
What makes you think he was dead? The same as what?
When I was a little girl.
The day you were attacked?
Uh-huh.
Well, what does that tell you?
What?
Well, you are back where it all happened. I mean, everything around you, everything. Must have...
I was there and I saw him.
Like the man in the woods?
No, no. No, I haven't seen him, but I knew he was there. And there was someone in the house.
Who?
Oh, I've never seen him. I've just heard him breathing.
Breathing?
It was the same as